has to be supported by the president. If your president's not going to support that, I'm preaching to the choir. You might as well not really pursue a new brand if the president's not going to support you, because the president is the face of the university, whether you like it or not, and they are the ones that are going to have to really promote this. They have to be committed 100% to the process. And there's a difference between being committed and them complaining or bringing concerns. They can be committed, but one thing that you have to realize is that the president has a lot of skin in the game when you're rebranding. So one of the top reasons why presidents get fired is a failed rebrand or changing the mascot or the name. And so Jordan will tell you, I was really moody for many, many times. And what I really appreciated about his approach was I'd call up and say, you know, I'm getting all these emails about, you know, we're going to be the Sun Warriors, or we're going to be this, and why not the Rebels, and this and that. And he did not panic. He just talked through to keep to the process. And so he knew that I had a lot of skin in the game. I had shared that, you know, I really don't want to go into this, but as a university community, we decided to go through this process. I was committed to the process, but it didn't mean I wouldn't have fears, that I wouldn't have moments where I was doubting the direction we were going. And so what I appreciated about our marketing team was that he understood that. He tried to diffuse that and tried to talk me through that. And then the commitment to the implementation, as you saw from my police chief, you cannot give in. And I wish I could say this is once in every week or two, but this is constant. I constantly get, you know, but we are tech, and logo just doesn't blend with tech, or we're this. And, you know, I even had our diversity committee that painted our DSU rainbow colors for that. And I said, no, we're just not going to do that. And so those are the three main areas for the president that you as a marketing professional, if you can convince your president that one, this is the process, we need a new brand. Two, they have to be committed to the process. Can't look back, they can't cancel halfway through, and they have to be committed to the implementation. In fact, the last time I was in San Antonio, it was for the Pac West meeting, our athletic conference, and they had just sent Love Communication the first draft of the logos. And they were less than pleasant. And I went off my athletic director, I called Jordan, I said, there's no way in hell I'm going to lose my job over this, and blah, 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 and just gave him an earful. And immediately he just said, these are the first drafts. You gotta understand the process. And you tell us how to critique these. What do you want and what do you like and that? And he calmed me down. I wish I could say that only happened once. But I learned a lot. So if I sat down with the president, I would tell him, don't panic. You know, I've been there, I've done that. But being committed to that process, just know that your president's going to need support through that process to understand it. We're not marketing professionals. We don't understand most of it. Some will understand more than others, but you have to help us through the process. The second part was the case for us. The best thing, I think, for a president to do in marketing professionals is really make a strong case for the branding change. As I mentioned before, when I first took the job, I did not want to make any changes to the logo. I didn't like the logo. I thought it was ridiculous. I didn't appreciate it at all. But as we went through the strategic planning process, as I mentioned earlier, that's what everybody wanted to talk about. So the strategic planning process helped us gather a lot of data. A lot of data of why our brand wasn't working, a lot of data of how people felt about us, a lot of people that were no longer supporting us. And so we created a strong case, and through that strategic planning process, we had a lot of buy-in. And so I felt like I had coverage as a president that, oh, here we go. 3 years ago, we created the Red Storm, now So once we had that case, we really had to sell our strategic plan. And for me as a president, selling the strategic plan was also selling the need for rebranding. And so we came up with six goals. And when this was introduced to the public, it was introduced as the university and the community strategic plan for their university. And you'll see that goal six right here was established a strong brand and identity. And so anytime I got a little bit of flack about whether we're gonna go back to the Rebels, whether we're gonna have a new brand, I could say the community and our campus community have spoken. We are going to do this. We are unified on this. This is not my idea. And so that gave me a little bit of coverage. Not that every president needs a lot of coverage, but as Jordan will share with you tomorrow, getting rid of the Rebel name was like killing everyone's firstborn. And it was not a pleasant thing in our community. And there was a lot of anger. And I'll share with you tomorrow how many angry alumni showed up on my doorstep the first couple of weeks. And they shared their candid thoughts about the Red Storm. So as we implemented the strategic plan, every goal has strategies. And this was created by the strategic planning committee. And so you have our brochure there. And so in goal six, there was four strategies. We created co-team leaders for every goal. And so Jordan and then our athletic director are the two goal leaders for goal six. And then each strategy, we as a campus selected a group of 5 to 8 individuals to serve as the committee for each of these strategies. And then they had a goal leader. Now, against my will, I was the leader for strategy one, which I didn't really appreciate, but everybody felt like I needed to lead that, and so I did that. And so the way that our strategic plan works, each year we ask them to create a work plan. And so each strategy has several objectives, the things of work they're going to do to achieve those goals, and we have a number of goals that we want to accomplish. And so they will submit this work plan, and they'll ask for a certain budget. And then we'll assign them budget. So the first year, we had $50,000 for an agency, and then we had $100,000 for employment.